Hi, I'm Ellen from the Chili Dog. I'm in the process of knitting a bottom-up hat with some of my hand-spun yarn. Since I'm not following a pattern, I had to make decisions about the hat dimensions and shaping, and that involved just a little bit of simple math. Since a lot of knitters are intimidated by the math related to knitting, today I'm going to help you untangle the process of determining how many stitches need to be cast on to create your desired hat circumference, and how to evenly space the decreases at the top of the hat. Before we begin, I would like to emphasize that you must know your stitch and round gauge before you begin knitting your finished piece. If you don't know your gauge, you won't have enough information to solve any problems. Also remember that your gauge should be measured on fabric that has been washed and blocked in the same way you intend to wash and block your finished project. For this hat, my gauge is 22 stitches and 30 rounds per 4 inches. Let's get started. Before we begin, if you'd prefer ad-free access to every tutorial in our searchable and neatly organized library, head over to thechilidog.com and join our pack. A basic membership unlocks all of our content, or treat yourself to that, plus free patterns, including all of our new releases, and more. Whenever I'm solving a problem, I like to start by listing the things that I already know. I know my gauge is 22 stitches and 30 rounds per 4 inches. I also know that my head is 21 inches around and about 6.5 inches wide. The first problem I needed to solve before I cast on was how many stitches do I need around the hat circumference? For the best fit, you usually want your hat to be just a little bit smaller than your head. It's reasonable for a hat circumference to be about 90% of your head circumference. Now the math. 90% of 21 inches is 0.9 times 21 inches, or 18.9 inches. That just means I want my hat to be about 18.9 inches around, but it will be okay if it's just a little bigger or a little smaller than that. Next, I need to figure out how many stitches are in 18.9 inches. Hat circumference in stitches equals the hat circumference in inches times the gauge. I'll plug in my numbers, and my hat circumference in stitches equals 18.9 inches times 22 stitches per 4 inches, which equals 103.95 stitches. Obviously, I can't knit 103.95 stitches, but this number tells me that my hat needs to be about 104 stitches around to fit comfortably. I had a stitch pattern in mind for my hat, so before I cast on, I double-checked to make sure using it would give me an appropriate hat circumference. My stitch pattern was worked across a multiple of 18 stitches. If I repeat 18 stitches 6 times, it works out to 108 stitches. 108 stitches is close enough to my estimated 104 stitches to give me a decent fit, so I knew my stitch pattern would work. Before we do any more math, I'm going to add that to the information I know about my hat shaping. I know that the initial circumference of my hat is 108 stitches. Now, I'll admit, I did not do a lot of planning when it came to how far I knit before the shaping occurs. Since this is a personal, just-for-fun project and not one of my designs that other people will be knitting, I tried on the hat as I was knitting to determine where I wanted the shaping to begin. As I shape the top of my hat, I'm choosing how many stitches there will be at the end of the shaping. Since my hat has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 distinct sections, I'll end my hat shaping when there are 2 stitches left in each section, or has a final circumference of 12 stitches. That way I'll be able to just pull my yarn tail through the final 12 stitches to finish things off. I'm also choosing to decrease 2 stitches in each section on each decrease round. So 12 stitches will be decreased every time I work a decrease round. And just in case you're wondering, depending on your yarn weight and the size of your hat and how you want it shaped, decreasing between 4 and 16 stitches per decrease round would be a reasonable way to shape the top of a hat. Before I figure out how to evenly space my decrease rounds to shape the top of my hat, I'll note that my final circumference is going to be 12 stitches and that I'm decreasing 12 stitches in each decrease round. To determine the spacing of the decrease rounds, we need to know how many stitches will be decreased. That's just the initial circumference minus the final circumference. For my hat, I start with 108 stitches and end with 12 stitches. When I subtract it out, I know I'll be decreasing 96 stitches. Let's figure out how many decrease rounds to work. That's just the number of stitches decreased. We just figured that out. Divided by the number of stitches decreased in each round. 96 stitches divided by the 12 stitches decreased in each decrease round means I'll need to work 8 decrease rounds. Before I can figure out how to space the decrease rounds, I need to know how many total shaping rounds there will be. Since the width across my head is about 6.5 inches, I think I'm going to shape my hat over a little less than half that distance, or about 3 inches. 3 inches times my gauge, 30 rounds per 4 inches, means I'll be working the shaping over about 22.5 rounds. Of course, I can't actually knit 22.5 rounds. However, for now, let's not worry about that. The final piece of math is to calculate the spacing of the decrease rounds. It's just going to be the number of shaping rounds that we just solved for divided by the number of decrease rounds that we have also already solved for. 22.5 total rounds divided by 8 decrease rounds gives us 2.8 total rounds for every 1 decrease round. Since we can't work partial rounds, I'm going to round that 2.8 up to 3. What that means in my actual knitting is that I will knit a round, and work a decrease round, then repeat that sequence 8 times. Now that we've worked everything out, I'm ready to knit the top part of my hat. I hope this lesson helped you untangle most of the math involved with hat knitting, so you can try setting your patterns aside next time you want to knit a hat of your own. Until we stitch again, happy knitting.